Cooper got a strong response in his last game. He's looking for it again in this one, the rubber match.
Referees are T.J. Luxmore and John Hebert, Johnny Murray and Kyle Flemington. Over the net into Coleman, try to pull it down and could not. Move back into the middle of the ice, lead pass for Duclair. He can fly. Duclair in there. Great stop by McElhinney as he drags the pad and takes it away.
Really fly. Look at number 91. He's able to split in between the D and look at McElhinney. McElhinney ended up behind the net. The Lightning D didn't quite read the speed. It doesn't matter if the guy has the puck yet or not. When a guy has speed like Duclair, he's going to get the puck.
There's a bounce to Stamkos, puts it back to the line. Kicks back to the captain, quick shot, and it goes just wide. Net near side now by Chernak. Chernak hit by Lomberg out in front. Chernak to Stamkos, one-timer, scores! Steven Stamkos, welcome back to the lineup. Drills it, 1-0 Lightning.
Steven has a rebound come back to him. Watch number 81, just the top of your screen, right there. But he has a presence of mind. I'll bet you Stammer was yelling over there. Stammer wasn't trying to go to the front of the net with everybody else. No, I'm over here at the faceoff dot. You know where he lives. You play three straight games, it is a lot like the playoffs. The players have a real individualized feel for each other. That's a real important thing.
There's a turnover behind the net, and it is in. Jonathan Huberdeau with a gift. And a wide open net, and we are all tied 1-1.
On the forecheck, Panthers do a terrific job. What happens to McElhinney here? The puck seemed to stick on him a little bit. He wasn't quite sure exactly how fast it was going to come around. I wonder if that hit sort of a little bump in the yellow kick plate around the bottom, because it seemed to completely fool McElhinney.
Radko Gudas up on the play, finishes the play with a hit, as he often does. That one on Sergachev. Jars the puck free for the Panthers. Wraparound attempt. Dropped out to Weger. Snaps one, and that did not miss by much. And tipped the crossbar and up and out of play. Weger is a guy who's been getting better and better the last few seasons.
Yeah, and he's a really good match with Ekblad. He's sturdy. Weger knows how to figure it out.
Little turnover out in front for Tippett. Scores! Owen Tippett buries it, and he gives the Panthers the lead 2-1.
And then the Lightning just mishandle it. A little play under pressure by Ruda, and it flipped over backwards on his tape. He knew he was in trouble. That was Vetrano who X'd him out right along the boards, and then Tippett is able to get a beautiful pass from Lossirainen. And he makes the right shot just over the pass.
Johnson had two goals in that game. Killorn in front to Coleman, and he is stopped by Drieger. Faceoff pulled back to the point. Sergachev made a little toe drag move and turned it over. Now racing away back the other way. Here comes Petrano in there, and he got it on the backhand. Couldn't finish on a big rush off the ice.
Penalty shot.
So 26-year-old Frank Petrano with a chance to extend this lead to two goals. One-on-one with Curtis McElhinney on the penalty shot. Scores! He snapped that one home.
Good quick hands. Let's see where McElhinney is depth-wise. He's backing up. He's in the paint a little, anticipating maybe a cutback shot to his glove side. A little late reacting there, but Vetrano didn't have much room. Here's a really good look. See how much room is on the glove side?
They've done a fan of the first attempt, second attempt on the way, and he hit Palat in front of the net. Point can't hold it, and now here comes Duclair winding it up. Anthony Duclair takes it wide all the way around. Wrap around! What a goal by Anthony Duclair! You talk about speed. How's that for your first goal as a Florida Panther? And it's 4-1.
This, watch his footwork coming around behind the net. McDonough's got him covered, but he opens up the 2-12. That's the way you have to do it, coming around on your forehand. Watch him open his feet up. Power skating teaches you that right now. It allows you to get your stick and your hands way ahead of the rest of your body and gives an advantage to you.
Three goals for the Panthers in his second period, Ryan, in 5 minutes and 24 seconds. Now Volkov snaps a shot, scores! Alex Volkov goes in back-to-back games and gets the second on the board for the Lightning. It's 4-2.
To really catch fire. They know he's got all kinds of potential and a great shot, and he proves it right here. Really good speed. How's that for a sniper? He's on a bad angle. He gets his head up, just outside the dot, doesn't get in too close. I think he surprised Driegger. Driegger wouldn't know a lot against Volkov.
Ryan McDonough near side boards, looks all the way up the ice and finds the target. Stamkos trying to break in, following up was Gord, and the Panthers bend but don't break. Here's a space pass, skating into it this time is Barkov. What a goal! Alex Barkov answers right back for the Panthers, and it's 5-2.
Act with tremendous speed. That's just an excellent play. I think that's Verhaeghe, who just kind of chipped that through to the blue line, but attacking away from the puck with speed. And look at the speed Barkov's got, and he's got way too much skill and speed and size. Fending off that stick by Ruda, who couldn't do anything much more than that. Beautiful move.
And Jamel Smith gets after that loose puck, centering attempt, and Oskrom scores! Maroon finds it, gets the backhander upstairs, and the Lightning get back within three.
A fourth line comes through big again. I didn't know if Maroon or Volkov had scored this one again. Who gets credit for it? Work along the wall by Maroon and then by Smith. As Smith is patient, a little pinball action there. See, they both do it, but Maroon actually has his stick blade on the puck, and Volkov shoots Maroon's blade.
Against a very determined Panthers team tonight.
And you know what? And that was Jamel Smith again. After a terrific game last game, great play.
2-on-1, Joseph across to Johnson, scores! Tyler Johnson, and it is game on again at Amalie Arena.
They got a little momentum, and they really use it. There's the pass that catches four Florida Panthers. Nice long pass from Sergachev right here to Joseph. And then Joseph executing, he's a lefty on the right wing side. And then Tyler Johnson, does he ever contort his body well to get this?
Here's Hedman at center, chips it near side. Palat banks it back to Stamkos. Back up top for Hedman. Across to Stamkos, quick shot, great save by Driegger as he came across with that right pad.
Plays there, the heads up quick pass to Stamkos right here. And Stammer, I don't know how many guys could even get that off, never mind get it on net. He didn't get a lot on it.
Gudas pressure to the point, little backhander in towards the net, and it's kicked back to the line. Here's Stroman with a shot, he scores! Anton Stroman goes upstairs and gets the sixth goal of the night for the Florida Panthers.
It's a beauty. Excellent puck movement here, just a little fake to the inside and goes outside. It's the screen in front, and it was actually Chernak, McElhenney's own teammate, that I think just crossed right in front of his eyesight, and he never saw it. Look at this. This is a great look at it. Look at McElhenney.
The Lightning zone. Sergachev makes the first pass and then into the middle for Stamkos, quickly up to point. Point steps in. Brayden Point stopped by Driegger, got just enough on the hard charging point. Tries the opposite side with his partner Ekblad. Ekblad bank pass in behind everybody, stepping in, a chance and a save by McElhenney on Connolly, who snuck in behind the D.
And Victor Hedman with a huge stick play.
Absolutely. Now in front is a chance, and Killorn couldn't finish on the back end. Penalty call coming up here. It's going to be a slash. Holman in behind the net, trying to throw it out in front, and he's not going to get there. It comes around the boards, and the Florida Panthers are going to hand the Tampa Bay Lightning their first defeat on home ice this season.